Our Shalom, I'm Dai Rastafari, and greetings to all of us. This will be short concerning the MOVE organization. A little bit more specifically, we're going to be going over this Wikipedia article, but we'll focus on the 1985 Philadelphia bombing of the MOVE organization members' residence, which ended up or resulted in the burning down of a whole neighborhood, including non-MOVE members. And so just to, not going too deep into this, but just to raise awareness concerning the crimes against humanity, the state crimes against the House of Israel, the Hebrew peoples in the Americas. So now it reads here, MOVE, or the MOVE organization, is a Philadelphia-based black liberation group founded by John Africa. MOVE was described by CNN as a loose-knit, mostly black group whose members all adopted the surname Africa, adopted a back-to-nature lifestyle, and preached against technology. The group lived communally and frequently engaged in demonstrations or public demonstrations related to issues they deemed important. Excuse me. So now, since their founding in 1972, MOVE has been in frequent conflict with the Philadelphia Police Department. A major incident occurred in 1978 when the police raided their Powelton village home. This raid resulted in the imprisonment of 9 group members, now known as the MOVE 9. After this, the group relocated further west to a house at 6221 Osage Avenue. In 1985, the group made national news when police dropped a bomb on the Osage House from a helicopter in an attempt to end an armed impasse or something like that. The explosion and ensuing fire killed 11 people, including 5 children and the group's leader, John Africa. Only 2 occupants survived, Ramona, an adult, and Bertie, a child. In addition, approximately 60 others, non-MOVE affiliated homes were destroyed as the entire block burned. Now, we'll add to this, not only were 11 people, MOVE members, found killed, but they were burned alive with, and they found, bullet scraps, impaled upon their flesh, in large amounts, I guess, and we include that because we actually saw the footage of the burnt bodies and stuff like that, and they actually, Philadelphia Police Department actually let the whole neighborhood burn down. The firemen or firefighters, so called, were present at the scene, but were not authorized to put the fire out until many hours after the incident. And so, and the only reason we're bringing this forth is because we had no idea, and now that we know, okay, we're gonna go forward so just briefly. 1985 bombing. In 1981, MOVE relocated to a row house at 6221 Osage Avenue in the Cobbs Creek area of West Philadelphia. Neighbors complained for months that MOVE members were broadcasting political messages by bullhorn at all hours, and also about the health hazards created from piles of compost. On May 13, 1985, after the complaints as well as indictments of numerous MOVE members for crimes including parole violation, contempt of court, illegal possession of firearms, and making terrorist threats, the police department attempted to clear the building and arrest the indicted MOVE members. This led to an armed standoff with police. The police lobbed tear gas canisters at the building. MOVE members fired at the police, and the police returned fire with semi-automatic weapons. Okay. A Pennsylvania State Police helicopter then dropped 2 1-pound bombs made of FBI-supplied water gel explosive, a dynamite substitute, targeting a fortified bunker-like cubicle on the roof of the house. The resulting fire ignited the massive blaze that eventually destroyed approximately 60 houses nearby. 11 people, including John Africa, five other adults, and 5 children died in the resulting fire. Ramona Africa, one of the 2 survivors, claimed that police fired at those trying to escape the burning house, while the police stated that MOVE members had been firing at police. So, I mean, obviously this is kind of like, I guess not the best article to read, but, you know, just clearly taking sides. And regardless of, you know, maybe the MOVE organization may or may not have been going about things the most proper way, but nonetheless, you know, what is proper considering the atrocities and crimes against humanity committed by these European American immigrants upon, you know, landing on this land, or setting foot on this land rather. And so basically, regardless, no one in situations like these, no one ever gets condemned for any crimes. The state, it goes free, clean, while innocent people die, children burned alive, shot at, stuff like that. So, you know, yeah, we'll just pause right there. Shalom Rat Eferek.